Hello everyone. In this video, I will explain the first script I have shared to you. The script name is GEE_exercise1. I've already shared the link with you, so it should be available in your repository if you have saved it. So the first step is to get the link, do some editing, maybe just a comment, start of the comment, and the save button will appear. Then you can save it to your own repository. So in this script, the first part of the script is where you import data. And you can see that I have imported the digital surface model, the global at 30 meter. You can also click here and see the details. And I have also imported the Urmia boundary lake basin, and I have named it ULB. It's the same shapefile which I have shared to you. You have access to my data already. Users Esperith module 11 Urmia_boundary. That is why you are able to run this script, because I have given access to all of you to this data. But you can also upload the shapefile into your assets and change this into calling the data from your own repository. So both ways, okay. The thing is, at some point, if I decide to delete this, you will not be able to access this any longer. So it's better to get it accessed from your repository itself. But for time being, it will work. Now, the print DSM means anything with print, print of any object. So all the variable definition, these are all objects. And print a object means it will print the details of the object in the console. So anything with print will appear here. Now the first step, or the second step after importing data, is I have defined two palettes. One palette for elevation, and given some parameters. For example, I just want to visualize from 1000 to 3000 meters using this palette. So that's what you do here. You can take it as an example and use it for any other use case. Now I want my study area to be around ULB, so I am going to center the map view around ULB at a zoom scale 8. Now we are selecting the DSM, because DSM has three bands. So I'm going to select, using this select command, the first band, the name. So the print DSM will give you all these details, or if you go here, you can see all these details. If you go to bands, you can see that there are four bands, and the first band is what we actually need. It consists of the elevation, AVE_DSM. So that is why I decided to select AVE_DSM and clip to ULB. And I'm printing that DSM_ULB into console again to see how it looks. Now I'm adding this layer again, this DSM_ULB here, using the elif parameters which we have set here, giving a name which will appear here. Now this part of the code will compute average elevation and save into a variable AVG_DSM. So when you give print AVG_DSM, it will print the average elevation here. And for computing the statistics, you have to use something called reduce region. Please check the documentation. And I have used a reducer called mean. So the aggregation in Google Earth Engine is usually called as reduce. So this is how mean is calculated. If it is sum instead of mean, you will use sum there. Now we are going to create a mask for elevation higher than 2500. So we'll say, we'll assign a new variable DSM_mask. And that is where you're going to store all the DSM_ULB greater than, GT means greater than 2500. So it will put all the pixels which has a value greater than 2500 to DSM_mask, and all the other pixels will be set to zeros. Now we don't want zeros. So the next line, we want, instead of zeros, we want no data. So this line will, using the command update mask, will set all the zeros to no data. If you check the documentation, you will get a clear idea what update mask will do. Now I'm adding the ULB and the last DSM underscore mask. Now in this part of the code, you are going to compute the area for elevation. So you can see that I have computed the number of pixels, multiply by the resolution of the pixel, and then sum them. So that is pretty much it. If you run it, you can see that it will show all the print over console here. And it will show you, so whatever layers are added at with using map.add layer will show here. So you can comment according to what you want. And yeah, customize your script. So this is the area, this is in meter square, so 2811 square kilometer. Thank you.